coordinated. We put out the mailers to the same people, same 50,000 people in our home banking universe. And then once we got the mailers, and once we get them back, we know which of these addresses don't work anymore. And then we started drafting our precinct walking list. So we went out, I think, 5 or 6 times in LA and in parts of Orange County. And so we kind of matched those up with the curves that we built through our mailers and our phone program. And then once we did our rounds of phone banking, mailer, and precinct walking, then in the last week and a half, we did what we call GOTV calling and walking. So just contacting those same voters who we already talked to and who we already ID'd as supporting us or unsure, but we still believe we can get them to come support Prop 30. And we gave them another round of either calls or door knocks. And then on election day, we had a lot of fun, actually. So we chose about 8 precinct locations in Koreatown. We sent a couple of volunteers to each one to check in on the voter rolls, how many people voted that were Korean American that matched up with our list at 4 o'clock, at 6 o'clock, at 8 o'clock. And once we checked it up and matched it up, we just started calling them on their cell phones, like, hey, it's 7 o'clock, you got 30 minutes to come vote, get your ass over here. You know? A little bit nicer than that, but, because we know some of these people, our office, the Korean Resource Center, is also a polling location, so these are people like literally across the street. So we ran that program to, I believe we contacted about, how many people did we contact on election day? Maybe 500 calls, 1,000 calls?
Not a lot, chaotic. Like 300.
Pretty chaotic that day. And then throughout the whole period, we had a lot of workshops. People, community members, especially seniors, come into KRC to get assistance filling out their vote-by-mail ballots. So I believe we filled out 1,200 vote-by-mail ballots, which is great because then we know they voted for Prop 30 and against 32 because we fill out the bubbles for them, right? We showed them where to fill it out. So we had a lot of fun doing that. We had a couple community events. We had a town hall with some elected officials. We had some rallies in the street, one with kids, one with seniors. We had various events at senior centers and churches and schools. And yeah, that was just the overall strategy we used in terms of the order of what we did. And I guess some 2 tips that we learned is to integrate as much voter data as possible. So even when we're canvassing at a market or going to a senior workshop, we try to identify the voters that will be there beforehand, if it's possible. For example, if we're going to a senior apartment, like a big downtown Korean-American low-income senior apartment, we can access their data through VAN and we can identify them beforehand and then check them up on the voter list as they come in. Whenever we do surveys, whenever we go out to the markets, we try to formulate our like survey pages so they would match up in Excel with the VAN so that we can import that back and then export it back out afterwards. It didn't always work out because people write their names differently on a survey form than they do in their official voter data, but it kind of worked sometimes. And then we're still experimenting with things like targeted, paid social media voter contacts, like paid Facebook contacts, paid Google ads. So